or status. Each person is valuable, not because of his productivity or age, but because we are human, created by God in his own image and likeness. And neither economics nor emotions should alter the length of each person's gift to humanity.
EWTN. Live truth. Live Catholic.
Family, a prayer that we pray together is a powerful prayer. So please pray together with me our EWTN family prayer. Today we pray for those suffering from natural disasters. Almighty God, we humble ourselves before you, the creator of all things visible and invisible. So many throughout the world suffer from the forces of nature. Have mercy on them, O Lord. So many have died from disasters. Give them eternal rest, O Lord. Do not look on our sins, but on our faith in you. We place all of our hope in your goodness. Calm the storms, bring gentle rains to our lands, and let your people live in tranquility and peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Behold the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood.
This morning on the feast of St. Norbert, we welcome also with us to have Father Frank Bassa from the Diocese of Cleveland and Father Jared Orndorff, also from the Diocese of Cleveland, and Father Melvin Castro from the Diocese of Tarlac in the Philippines. Let us pray in the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Savior Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, let us prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries and ask God to show us his mercy. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my mysterious fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Bishop St. Norbert, a servant of your church, outstanding in his prayer and pastoral zeal, grant, we ask, that by the help of his intercession, the flock of the faithful may always find shepherds after your own heart, and be fed in the pastures of salvation through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the beginning of the second letter of St. Paul to Timothy. Apostle of Christ Jesus by the will of God, for the promise of life in Christ Jesus. To Timothy, my dear child, grace, mercy, and peace from God the Father and Christ Jesus our Lord. I am grateful to God, whom I worship with a clear conscience, as my ancestors did, as I remember you constantly in my prayers, night and day. For this reason, I remind you to stir into flame the gift of God that you have through the imposition of my hands. For God did not give us a spirit of cowardice, but rather of power and love and self-control. So do not be ashamed of your testimony to our Lord, nor of me, a prisoner for his sake, but bear your share of hardship for the gospel with the strength that comes from God. He saved us and called us to a holy life, not according to our works, but according to his own design and the grace bestowed on us in Christ Jesus before time began, but now made manifest through the appearance of our Savior Christ Jesus, who destroyed death and brought life and immortality to light through the gospel, for which I was appointed preacher and apostle and teacher. On his account I am suffering these things, but I am not ashamed, for I know him in whom I have believed, and am confident that he is able to guard what he has entrusted to me until that day. The word of the Lord. To you, O Lord, I lift up my eyes.
To you, O Lord, I lift up my eyes.
To you, I lift up my eyes, who are enthroned in heaven. Behold, as the eyes of servants are on the hands of their masters.
You, O Lord, have lifted up my eyes.
As the eyes of a maid are on the hands of her mistress, so are our eyes on the Lord, our God, till he have pity on us.
You,
for this gloom. Lectio Sancti Evangelii Secundum Marcum. Some sad Jews, who say that there is no resurrection, came to Jesus and put this question to him, saying, Teacher, Moses wrote for us, if someone's brother dies, leaving a wife but no child, his brother must take the wife and raise up descendants for his brother. Now there were seven brothers. The first married a woman and died, leaving no descendants. So the second brother married her and died, leaving no descendants, and the third likewise, and the seventh left no descendants. Last of all, the woman also died. At the resurrection, when they arise, whose wife will she be? For all seven have been married to her. Jesus said to them, Are you not misled? Because you do not know the scriptures or the power of God. When they rise from the dead, they neither marry nor are given in marriage, but they are like the angels in heaven. As for the dead being raised, have you not read in the book of Moses, in the passage about the bush, how God told him, I am the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob. He is not the God of the dead, but of the living. You are greatly misled. Verbum Domini. Our two readings have a good deal of relevance to this feast of Saint Norbert, who was born in 1080 AD, born to a very wealthy man, a nobleman. I believe he was a duke and a relative of the emperor. And this meant that, of course, his oldest brother would inherit the title and the property. And of course, mom and dad want to do something nice for the young kids. So, in his case, he was made a subdeacon. And then given, the church was given a large amount of money to support him to chant the office. But he didn't want to go on for ordination to the priesthood. He didn't quite want that responsibility, so he stayed as a subdeacon, but kept the money, of course. In fact, what he did is he hired another guy to do the singing for him, and he went to the court of the emperor, where he got paid to be a chaplain, and he got a few other tasks. And he was making a lot of money, because one of the things that was going on, this was a time of great tension in the church. There had been in 150 years earlier, a series of very, very bad popes. What made them so bad? They were trying to use the papacy to have political power in Italy. And they got manipulated and did some of the manipulating to get that power. As a result of how crazy it got, especially in the early 1000s, the emperor came in and cleared out, this is stop, this is, I'm going to take control, I'm going to put things back in order. But then that led to a new problem. Namely, the politicians took control of the church for their own manipulations. So one of the emperors was a saint, in fact, Emperor Henry. But and he's still Saint Henry, one of the first actually go through the process of formal canonization. But his successors were not so holy. And they wanted to appoint the bishops. Why? Why would they want to appoint bishops? They were concerned that if they put bishops in cities, they could stay in control of the cities. The bishops also ruled the cities politically. So they had the political power and the spiritual power, and if the emperor kept changing them out, when they died, because they wouldn't have any legitimate children, so they would die, and then the emperor could put his own guy in there, and that kept control of the cities with the emperor or the king. And it was all about power. And it was very easy to find priests who would go along with it because you could make a lot of money and have a very, very lucrative existence. And that's exactly what Norbert was trying to do. As a matter of fact, he still didn't want to be ordained a priest, so he didn't want to be ordained a bishop. He was offered to be a bishop and all this kind of thing. He said, no, I want something a little easier than that, but I want the money. So he took various jobs and kept adding them on, hiring somebody else to do the job, and he got the majority of the money. Now, the reason I mention all this, the Sadducees were one of the parties in Israel's religion and in Judaism. One was the Pharisees. The Pharisees were primarily a party of lay people. The Sadducees were primarily a party of the priests and the nobles. Same kind of deal. That they also saw the priesthood not as this privilege by which you get to serve God, but it was a way to live a very good life. If you got into the top levels of the priest, the high priesthood, you go to the Sadducee neighborhood, that they had their own section of Jerusalem. And I've gone there, of course, many times, and I've seen the ruins of their houses. They are of a very top quality for that period of time. They look just like the houses that were found in Pompeii, which was destroyed about 10 years after Jerusalem. And you can see the top, the only difference is at the Sadducee's house, they didn't have any dirty pictures on the wall. In Pompeii, the Romans did, the pagans. But otherwise, they had a very comfortable life, very luxurious product. And they saw the priesthood as a way to make a good living. Of course, they denied the resurrection of the dead. Of course they would deny it. Why? Because it means that you are going to be judged by God at the end of your life as to whether you get the resurrection to glory, as the prophet Daniel says in Daniel chapter 12, so that you would shine like the sun, or you would be judged by God to go to everlasting condemnation. And as Daniel also says in the same verse of chapter 12, that you become an eternal nightmare, an everlasting horror or nightmare. And so they didn't even like the book of Daniel being in the Bible. So they didn't want that in their Bible. They didn't want anything that had to do with the resurrection. That they didn't like a lot of Isaiah, because he talked about the judgment. And the last thing that somebody who is living high off the hog while they're claiming to work for God want to believe in is that God is going to judge them for the way they live. And so the Sadducees denied the resurrection of the dead, and they had to reject a lot of books of the Bible right on out there. They basically kept the first five, and that was it. But it didn't talk about the resurrection or the judgment and such. And that's why when our Lord responds to them here with his teaching, they're giving a crazy situation. It is the law of Moses, which they would know. They would know the law of Moses. It was the law of Moses that if a brother dies childless, the widow has to marry the next oldest brother. Because then the child would actually belong to the dead brother, so that that child, even though it's physically the child of the next brother, it would be legally the child of the first one who died. And he could inherit that brother's property. That was the idea. And so they come up with this crazy situation. And Jesus cuts through all that. It's not about legal fine points, because in heaven you don't have marriage. Why not? Because you don't have people giving birth to children. People don't have children up in heaven. So you don't have marriage. Now, does that mean you don't love your wife that you had here on earth, or your husband that you had here on earth? No, of course you love them even more if you're both in heaven. Love them far more. But it won't be marriage. Well, you know them? Of course you'll know them. But it won't be in the state of marriage because there's no need for reproduction. And so it's a different kind of relationship. And then Christ gives another principle, that which is, God is the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, right? The Jewish religion had a principle, God is the God of the living, right? Therefore, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob must be living. That was the logic he used. And he's doing that from the first five books, which the Sadducees had to accept. So he's using what they do accept on their level, even though it's a reduced Bible, they use that, and he shows that they're wrong. And that they actually had a great need to repent. And you see, it's not only in the Gospels. You see in the Mishnah, a book of collection of the sayings of rabbis, that they also said the Sadducees were very corrupt. Had a strong reaction against them. And Josephus, Jewish historian, writing about the 90s or so, he says the same thing. So this is something that's in agreement. Now, St. Norbert also had a lot of this desire for wealth and was not thinking of his final judgment at all. He was thinking about a lot of the pleasures, and he was using all this money not to put in the bank, but he was spending it on himself for all kinds of pleasure, no matter what it might be, as his biographer says. And as a result, one day he was riding his horse, which was a very expensive thing to have in those days. Horses were very expensive, still are. But riding a horse was like riding a Cadillac of the highest level, or maybe a Maserati, one of those other fancy cars. And a lightning bolt struck right in front of his horse. The horse threw him off, and he was unconscious for an hour. At that point, he began to realize his own mortality. He's going to die, as we all do. And that he's going to make an account of his life to God. And at that point, he then began to repent and began a life of very serious repentance. And he eventually went to the Pope, Gelasius II, and asked permission to be an itinerant preacher, that he would go around preaching. He needed permission for that, but he got it from Pope Gelasius to go and preach reform to the priests and monks in the area. He came across the Cistercians and other orders that had begun reform, and he learned from them. He had become too strict, and in fact, his first two companions died because they didn't eat enough and they didn't care for their health enough. There has to be a balance, and Benedictines are great at balance. So he learned that from the Cistercians, and at the same time learned reform.
then he was, despite this, he was made a bishop. He didn't want to be, but he was made a bishop. And he brought reform to the clergy that was so serious, the priests tried to assassinate him a number of times. Not the last bishop to experience that. St. Charles Borromeo was almost assassinated, shot in the back once while he was giving a synod to his priests. This was a time when that use of the power of the laity over the bishops and the priests led everybody to think, well, I can have my girlfriends living with me over in the rectory, and all the stuff, this was common. And St. Norbert was raised up by God in the way that St. Paul says here to Timothy. He stirred into flame the gift of God that he received by the imposition of hands. The laying on of hands is how the sacrament of the priesthood is passed on. The bishop lays hands on them. That's the act of the sacrament. And the same thing is true of the bishops, because this is a passing on of that gift of the priesthood and being bishop all the way back to Christ, who gave it to the apostles, and they passed it on, and Paul passed it on to Timothy, and as we'll see in this letter, Timothy was to pass it on to the next group of bishops after him. And this is very much what he is calling Timothy to do, stir into flame. The word that's used there means to take a stick in a fire that's already sort of gone down, a campfire, and you don't see much there, so stir it up with a stick and get the flames going again and put some wood back on it. Get going there so that it comes back into a flame of faith. And that's exactly what St. Norbert did. He started his own order, the Norbertines, also named after the place where they started at Prémontré. They're called the Prémonstratensians. And he began to realize that as he reformed his life, he knew that God did not give a spirit of cowardice. That's why he wasn't afraid when they tried to assassinate him, but they tried to scare him off. He wouldn't stop. He kept the reform going and eventually brought the clergy and the people of the town, who didn't mind having corrupt clergy because they didn't ask them to change their own corruptions. But they were corrupt, how are they going to ask you to change? But when Bishop Norbert came in, he called the clergy to reform, and then they called the people to reform, and it changed his diocese. And instead, they came to realize that it's not a spirit of cowardice, but a spirit of power and of love. Because it's not power by itself is what the emperors were trying to do in controlling the bishop. They wanted power by itself. But it's a spirit of power that comes from God as his gift. It's also a spirit of love, that you don't wield power for the sake of your own goals, but you wield power for the sake of building up other people and the salvation of their souls. That's what priests are called to do. And a spirit of self-control, so that you don't give in to your own desires, but you channel and control them. I always say, what's the difference between the Everglades and the Mississippi River? Everglades is a river. A lot of folks don't know that, but it's a flowing river. So is the Mississippi. But why do you have ships sailing on the Mississippi and not on the Everglades? Because the Everglades does not have any river banks. There's no limit. It's just spread out, and it's more like a swamp than a river. So also, with the guidance of the river banks, there is this control in the Mississippi that makes it a river. It has lots of other kind of more usefulness to us. And we have to make a decision. Will we allow that self-control and the control set by God's commandment to guide us as priests and as laity, so that we become far more nourishing than the Everglades. Let us bring our prayers and our needs before the Lord.
For the outpouring of the Spirit's gifts of wisdom and understanding upon our Holy Father in his guidance of the Church, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For widows and orphans, for the marginalized and the oppressed, and for unborn children and their mothers, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the community in which we live may be able to reach out to the young people who are hurt, depressed, or despairing. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have died in the peace of Christ may rejoice in eternal life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We also have been asked to pray for the Sisters of St. Joseph of the Third Order of St. Francis, a Polish-American community, where many of the sisters were avid fans of EWTN, but are quite elderly. I want to pray for them and all the other sisters who have served the church so well, and now that they prepare themselves by prayer, that they have a time of great expectation of seeing our Lord and our Lady. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. Lord, Heavenly Father, we ask that you hear these and all of our needs through Jesus, who is our Lord, forever and ever. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Receive, O Lord, we pray, the offerings placed on your altar in commemoration of Blessed Norbert, so that as you brought him glory, you may, through these sacred mysteries, grant to us your pardon through Christ
O Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as on the festival of Saint Norbert you bid your church rejoice, so too you strengthen her by the example of his holy life. Teach her by his words of preaching, and keep her safe in answer to his prayer. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim.
Sanctus, 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 Dominus,
In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing
the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son may be filled and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
And he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Norbert, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant, Francis our Pope, and Robert our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom we have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world.
To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
Salutaris moniti. Et divina institutione formati aut demus dicere
quatem poster qui es in genis sanctificet
Yeah.
obećanju što je ekzekutorio te katamu vijati, koja će nam adnije vokati su domine nam sam digno, u interesu tekme me setantom di gdeb, et se nabit.
For those who cannot now receive Jesus in the Blessed Sacrament, we offer the following prayer. Eternal Father, I offer up to Thee my intellect, that it may learn to know Thee alone. Sweetest Jesus, I offer up to Thee my memory, that it may remember Thee alone. Holy Spirit, Spirit of Charity, I offer up to Thee my will, that Thou mayest enkindle and warm it by Thy divine love. Adorn my soul with thy seven gifts, and let me become thy pure temple. Fill me with thy grace, and prepare my heart to receive spiritually my God. Jesus, my God, as I am unable to receive thee sacramentally, do thou receive me into thy heart, and unite me so perfectly with it that nothing may ever be able to separate me, even for a moment, from thee. Engulf my misery and my nothingness in the abyss of thy mercy, that I, changed into thee, may henceforth live only for thee, by thee, and in thee. Come, therefore, thou my only satisfaction, come to take possession of this heart, which belongs to thee, and cannot live one moment without thee. Amen.
Let us pray. Renewed by the sacred mysteries, we humbly pray, O Lord, that following the example of Blessed Norbert, we may strive to profess what he believed and to practice what he taught, through Christ our Lord.
Now there's a fast and easy way to get in touch with EWTN, the EWTN Everything Number. Call 1-800-447-EWTN to get the latest information on programming, special events, pilgrimages, and more. You can even make a donation by calling 1-800-447-EWTN. Our EWTN Family Viewer Services representatives are ready to help you with whatever your needs may be. It's easy, fast, and family-friendly. The EWTN Everything Number, 1-800-447-EWTN. EWTN.
EWTN. Live truth. Live.